How are you all doing? Good? Yes, nice to see you again. Nice being here and for this novena, especially in honor of our native Kaila family. And the theme that we are given today is what? Mary? Mary, mother of the world, mother of humanity. Mary, mother of the world, mother of humanity. Where do you think this title come from? Who gave this title? Yes. All of us could be right at least sometimes. It is right, I think. Other titles are popular devotions. There are many titles we give to Mary. Primarily they were instituted or say propagated by the ancient fathers of the church. But this particular title is very scriptural. Very, very scriptural. We saw in this reading. This title is given by Jesus himself. Woman, behold your son. And to John, what he said? Behold your mother. And the next sentence that follows these words is a very crucial sentence for us to understand how important Jesus felt that this task to be completed. I read that as my opening phrase. With that, Jesus knew that all was now finished. Until then, Jesus found that everything seemed to be incomplete. Jesus was at a crucial stage of his life, at the verge of dying. Everything is coming to an end. But which completes his life on earth is giving all of us unto the most loving care of this mother completes. That is where it is very crucial. Jesus, before his death, felt so disturbed that I am going to leave these of my beloved disciples, my beloved people. And so he decided that he has to leave behind something that will keep us with confidence, that will keep us in good stead. Therefore, he gave us three things. What are those? He gave on the Last Supper the body and blood, his living presence in the Eucharist. And here, Mother Mary as a completion. And for the future, he promises the Holy Spirit. My dear sisters and brothers, in the heart of Jesus and in the mind of Jesus, giving Mother Mary as a mother to all of us as a gift was a primary intention. Was a primary intention. Why at all he must choose to do this? Why do you think? All of us can be a little interactive. Why? You go to a shop and buy something and come. You know, next week you say, you know, you don't go to that shop, you go to that shop. There the mutton is very tasty and tender. All of us direct. Why? I experienced it. You go to that sweet shop, you know, that shop is not good. You go to that other one. Last week, you know, I collected this and it was very tasty, yummy. We direct because we experienced it. Jesus at the first place, first-hand experience of the love of the mother. And he couldn't have found anybody else more confident than to entrust all of us with than Mother Mary. He finds her as the most worthy person to surrender all of us. If they are with you, I am confident they are safe. If they are with you, I am confident they will be good stead. If they are with you, I am confident they will be good children. If they are with you, I am confident they will be loved and they will love in true sense. That is why Jesus gives. My sisters and brothers, in my opinion, I will take a few things from here and there in the gospel and try to substantiate how this mother stands as exemplary mother. What do you think is the key characteristics of being a mother? Key characteristics, very key. Caring and sharing, yes. Anybody else? Loving, yes. There lies something beyond that. Suffering. Suffering. Pain. That is the key characteristic. First, most important key characteristic of being a mother. Would you agree or not? We always see the good side of it. Would you agree or not? From conception, from womb to tomb, it is the mother who suffers on account of her children. And not condemning, not the condemnation, accepting it so gladly. It is pain, yet I take it with joy. What happens in the life of Mary? Son is lost. Say, from the conception, you see, first of all, a virgin, dilemma, confusion, Lord, how can a virgin conceive all that? Immediately after birth, flight into Egypt. After that, what happens? Loss in the temple. Then, people call him mad, dying in their own lap. This is the life of Mary with regard to Jesus. Suffering is a key characteristic. In all that, she was not a condemning mother. What we will do, everywhere I was looking for you. Correct? What we will do? Everywhere I was looking for you. Where did you go? What we will do is, somebody says, come, your son, they are calling him mad. This fellow, ever since he is born, this fellow, ever since he is born, my love is gone. Ever since he is born, my life is gone. This is the kind of attitude we probably have. Look at this mother. A mother who takes suffering with joy and remains committed to her call of being a mother. This is where she stands as an example to all of us. The most important thing about this suffering nature of Mother Mary is, because she suffered, she knows us. That is why she is promoted as a mother of the humanity. A mother who has suffered, who has gone through everything, just like you who are sitting here, just like you who are fathers and brothers, human beings sitting here. She is not a heavenly body like that, no, with all that glow. You go, you know, utter her, and then the heavenly choirs and angels singing, hallelujah, hallelujah, no. A mother who substantially and concretely went through suffering will understand when this boy goes and tells, Mama, you know, I'm finding it difficult. That is why Jesus makes her as a mother. And the implication of this is, every time you are troubled, every time you are puzzled, every time you are confused, every time you find no answer to some of the life situations, go to her. Behold your mother. He gave her to us so that we may be with her, so that we may find our confidence and strength in her. If we fail to look, that's whose mistake? That's whose mistake? It's our mistake. It's our mistake. That is why she is adored as a mother of the comforter of the afflicted. Look at that wedding at Cana. Normally what we will do? Something went wrong and everybody is running around. This mother's presence of mind, she goes to Jesus, intercedes. When everybody is so disturbed about what to do and what not to do, her presence of mind, just like any other mother, goes, searches, seeks for an answer and presents the difficulty to be gone away for the couple. All of us are married couple here. We are mothers and fathers, or at least will become so. Let us learn from her. Go to her, ask her. She will intercede for us. That is another, the second characteristic of a mother. The mother always looks, she may be here and there, but her eyes are always open. No, where is my child? The child will be about to fall, but will never fall. The mother will go and hold her tight. Take the child very tight. Love. Always the eyes are on the needs of the children. A mother who is interceding. Thirdly, she is a mother who gathers us like a chicken. Hen gathering around the chicks all around her. What happened at the beginning of the church? All the disciples thought they are lost at the death of Jesus. Scattered here and there. She brings them together in a close group, but praying. She invites the Holy Spirit among them because they were together in prayer, united in prayer. And that is why Jesus gave. He was aware. This mother will make the difference. That's why he gave this mother to us. My dear sisters and brothers, when we reflect upon her, as a mother of the humanity, mother of the church, if we fail to go to her, in spite of Jesus so concretely telling, at the last moment, when about to die, if somebody is about to die and they are, okay, this, no, I am giving as a precious something to you, and you take care of him. As a son and daughter, you will make sure that the promise is kept. Just about to die, and he is presenting his own mother, so that we could be confident and strengthened. If we don't go to her, if we don't pray to her, if we don't remain with her, it's our mistake. But every time you go to her, you will be strengthened. That's our message on this day, my dear sisters and brothers. Let's all close our eyes for a moment. Let's close our eyes. Become aware of this mother who is being gifted to us. We are not here because these novenas are simply conducted. We come and go. A mother who is so much with us, and we are honoring her. We are praying through her, and therefore we are going to pray now. All of you will repeat after me. O mother, of all of us, the suffering humanity, you who know all our sufferings and our hopes, you who have a mother, a mother's awareness of all the struggles between good and evil, between light and darkness, which affect us in this modern world, accept our cry, which we, moved by the Holy Spirit, address to your heart. Embrace us, Mother, with love. Grant all our petitions through Christ our Lord. Amen. This is the key sense. This prayer was formulated by Pope John Paul II, who is a saint now. He felt it so much. And he formulated this prayer. You who know my struggles, my pains, the difficulty between light and darkness, between suffering and pain, happiness, you take care of me. Let that be our prayer. Amen.